Hello, I'm Kyle Warman, Senior Application Engineer here at Opto 22. Today I'm going to show you the critical steps you'll need to know to connect your Modbus RTU device into groov. From a high level, we're simply going to take an RS-485 signal and put it onto a Modbus TCP network, which is especially useful because groov inherently speaks Modbus TCP. I'll be using the QuickServer by FieldServer to connect the Modbus RTU device directly into groov. The QuickServer is especially useful for Modbus RTU to Modbus TCP because of PEX mode, also called port expander mode, which I'll get into more in a minute. On the QuickServer, we'll be using all of the default DIP switch settings. And you can see here that it's wired with two wires for our RS-485 signal to our Modbus RTU device, and wired here into our Modbus TCP network, as well as our groov being on the same network. Now let's dig into the network settings for the QuickServer. The first thing we want to do is find our QuickServer and update the configuration file. To do this, open the FieldServer Toolbox software and look for the QuickServer that is connected to your Modbus RTU device. Now that we have established that the QuickServer is online and visited its web interface, we want to review the config file. Check the configuration file by opening pexmode.csv, downloaded from the link below. This file will tell our QuickServer how to configure its COM ports. You can see the various fields here, and you shouldn't need to make any changes. You will, however, want to make sure the port listed here is the same physical port that you've wired to your RS-485 signal. Once you are sure this is correct, save the file if changes have been made and go back to the QuickServer webpage. We want to load the configuration file, pexmode.csv, the same one we just edited, onto the QuickServer. To do this, on the left-hand side, click the drop-down and choose Setup. Here we will click on File Transfer and browse for the pexmode file. Choose pexmode.csv, click Open, and then Submit. This saves the file. Now go down to the bottom of the page for a system restart, which will make the new configuration file active. You can check to make sure it worked by reviewing the name on your QuickServer in the top left. It should now say pexmode. Before we tie everything together, we need to get a few register values from our Modbus RTU device. For your own application, you'll need a list of registers from the device manufacturer, similar to the list here, with specific register values for the information you want to bring into groov. I'll be using voltage, which is a float value that starts at register 1019, and frequency, which is also a float value, which starts at register 1033. These numbers are critical, and I'll show you why in a minute. Once you have your registers written down, head over to your groov build. As you can see here, I've already built a small page in groov for the Modbus RTU device. The only things left to do are add our device, create the tags, and assign them the gadgets. To add the Modbus device, we are actually adding the QuickServer gateway. Go to Configure Devices and Tags, and Add New Device. Select Modbus Device, give it a name, like Modbus RTU, then put in the IP address of the QuickServer. In our case is 10.192.158. Next, define the slave ID, which is set on your Modbus RTU device. My device is set to 4. Now we want to add the tags for voltage and frequency. Go to Configure Tags and click on the little plus sign in the top left. I'll name this first one Voltage. It's a float data type and its start address is 1019. Groov knows how to correctly address the tag based on its type and will autocomplete the tag address to the 400,000 value you see there. Now click Save and repeat this for any other tags you wish to add to your groov. I'm adding a second tag for frequency, but you can add as many tags as you need. Now I need to assign the tags to the gadgets I've already made. I'm using a value field, so it is easy to see the data. The first one here is voltage. The second is frequency. Now we save and go to groov view to make sure everything worked. We can see the correct and accurate voltage and frequency values coming from my Modbus RTU device directly into groov. All right, so there you go. You should be speaking with your Modbus RTU device directly into groov. And for more videos on groov, go to groov.com.